Today is the 28th day of the 11th month on our Maker's restored calendar. It is the 19th day of January on his servant Satan's calendar. And the end of the 11th hour is near at hand. Today we are 3 days' journey from the third dove waypoint. On this third dove waypoint, the Most High uncovered the 390 days of his chapter 4 end time Son of Adam prophecy and of the revelation of his only begotten Son's chapter 9, 6 trumpet, 4 messenger, Great Euphrates River prophecy. Today's 3 day journey from this revelation brings forth the 390th day of him causing his end time Son of Adam to petition him 3 times per day upon his holy mountain. His uncovering the timing of these 390 days has also uncovered the great and the fearful day of Kikwe. I will explain how it did so, but first I will address the false belief that no man knows the day or the hour. After his only begotten Son told his disciple that no man knew the day or the hour, not even the angelic host, he went on to tell them the following in verse 45. Who then is the faithful or the believing and wise servant whom his master has appointed upon his household to give him the food in its time? He said this after he said, at this time it will be as it was in the days of his servant Noah. And he said this in relation to after he said no man would know the day or the hour. The volume of as it was in the days of Noah that Kikwe has woven into his end time timeline has been spectacular to witness, especially recently with how he has caused the timing of the three doves to flow into the here and the now. Yeshua went on to add the following. Blessed is that servant whom his master finds doing so when he comes. Truly I say to you that he will appoint him upon all of his possessions. This is simply a reality that is at hand. In the following 3 verses, he went on to admonish those of you that have smitten his fellow servant that have been eating and drinking with the drunken as a result of the master of the house's delay. You have smitten Kikwe's second anointed son in your hearts and in your minds, and you have also smitten me through your stealing from him. You have remained eating and drinking with the drunken, feasting off of the leavened bread of men. The drunken are those who are drunk with the wine of fornication per Revelation chapter 17 verse 2 and chapter 18 verse 3. As a result of your doing so, being drunken, the Most High is going to cause you to drink of the wine of the fierceness of his wrath. The wine of your fornication that you are drunk with is your playing the whore to him by loving and worshiping and praising your idolatrous images of him that you want for him to be. Yeshua went on to tell us that this is the reason why this day and this hour are not known to you. You have remained eating and drinking with those who are drunk off of this wine of fornication instead of separating yourselves to the master of all of the earth. Daniel wanted to know when the great prince Michael was going to be sent onto the scene, and Kikwe told him that he would go sleep with his fathers and that this day would be sealed until the time of the end. What part of it will be sealed until the time of the end is too difficult for you to understand. Kikwe clearly told us that one would be sent to us at this time to proclaim the day and the year of his vengeance. He did so in Isaiah chapter 61. The spirit of Adonai Kikwe is upon me, referring to his 7 spirits being given upon his servant Zerubbabel per his Zechariah chapter 4 prophecy. On account of Kikwe has anointed me to bring news to the aware, he has sent me to gird those that will be broken of the heart, to cry out liberty to the captives, referring to the captives of Mystery Babylon, and to open the dual eyes of those that are bound, referring to those that are bound in Mystery Babylon. The Hebrew word for open is only used in this one place in the testimony of his word. It is the doubling of a word that means to open the eye. This word that means to open the eye is used 20 times in the testimony of his word, and every time that it is used in relation to opening the eye or opening the dual eyes. This Hebrew word for the aware is the word that the Most High used to describe his servant Moses. In Numbers chapter 12 verse 3, he tells us that his servant Moses was the most exceedingly aware of all of the atoms that were upon the faces of the soil. The King James usually translated this word as meek, or sometimes the lowly. Meekness or lowliness does not describe his servant that he drew out from the waters of Egypt. Just look at the events that Kikwe caused to take place with his servant Moses, and you should be able to acknowledge this. I don't think that meekness describes him when he cast the dual sets of the stone tablets to the earth and shattered them in pieces, or when he called for Kikwi to destroy Korah and his arrogant band that rose up against him and his brother Aaron. I don't think that meekness describes him when he killed the Egyptian and buried him in the sand, etc. No, his servant Moses was aware of Kikwi, and he was aware of his righteousness, and he was aware that he was Kikwi's chosen. Kikwi went on to add the following: to cry out the year of the delightful acceptance for Kikwi, and the day of the vengeance for our Elohim, to sigh of all of the lamenters, to put them that lament in Zion, meaning to deliver the remnant here to this place, those that will cry and sigh for all the abominations done in your midst, to give to them a head covering in place of ash, the oil of joy in place of mourning, the wrap of praise in place of the spirit of obscurity, and they will be called rams of the righteousness, the planting of Kikwi to his beautifying. Kikwe's word calls his end-time son of Adam the delightful acceptance of Kikwi. This is simply another reality that is at hand. If you want to deny his word and hold fast to the erroneous belief that no man will know the day or the hour at this time, this is certainly your choice to do so. If you do so, the day and the hour are going to come upon you like a thief in the night. His only begotten son said so. Yeshua's reference to the day or the hour is incredible. I say this because in a precise step-by-step, precept upon precept, measuring line upon measuring line, here a little, there a little manner, Yahweh has revealed to me that the one day of his hour and a day and a month and a year prophecy of his sixth trumpet is referring to the 168-day period of time, and the hour of this prophecy is referring to the 7 days of the seven vials of the seventh trumpet. I've spoken about these things in several other videos. Now that he has uncovered the 390 days of the year and the month, all we need to do is add the day and the hour to them. He revealed these 390 days to us through his four messengers that were bound in the great Euphrates River prophecy as being the four overlapping 280-day periods of time that he is using to bring forth Meher Shelah Kushbaz onto the scene. This is discussed in the last video that was produced 3 days' journey ago on his third dove waypoint. 280 days are the appointed time, dual appointed times, and half of an appointed time that the wife is fled into the wilderness upon the dual wings of a great eagle. He marked his end-time son of Adam with this 390-day revelation in association with 110 days from the beginning of the first 280 days. He marked his servant Noah 110 days after he shut off the waters. Zechariah means the mark of Kikwi. Kikwi also used his Zechariah prophecy to bring forth his uncovering of these 390 days 3 days ago. The Most High caused me to err in these four sets of 280 days by causing me to count from the first day of them instead of including the first day in the count, and what this error has brought forth is incredible. It has brought forth the fourth day of the ninth month being the first day of the 168 days of the great and the fearful day of Kikwe's wrath instead of it being the last day of the fourth 280-day period. The fourth day of the ninth month will fall on October 22nd, 2018 on his servant Satan's calendar. The final day of these 168 days will be on April 7th, 2019. This day will be on 2/20 on the Most High's restored calendar. This is the day that he caused our ancestors to depart from his holy mountain on their 11-day journey to the first entrance into the land of the promise when they got there they rebelled against the word of his mouth and would not go in to possess the land. He opened the ark's door 220 days after he marked his servant Noah. This 220 waypoint will be on the 1290th day from the end of the 1260 days of his 42-month witness against the scattered descendants of Israel. He spoke of these 1,290 days right after telling his servant Daniel that this day was going to be sealed until the time of the end. He does so in Daniel chapter 12. I'll start in verse 10. Many will be purified and made white and refined, and the wicked will be condemned, and none of all of the wicked will understand. I will repeat that. And none of all of the wicked will understand, but those who are the wise will understand. Isn't this an exact match to what Yeshua said after he said that no man knew the day or the hour back then at that time? But then he talked about the meat, the food being given to the wise? in its time? Keep in mind that this Daniel prophecy follows Shapeway's servant Daniel asking him when this great Prince Michael of chapter 12, verse 1, was going to be sent with these things, and Shapeway telling him that this time was going to be sealed until the time of the end. This is not complicated. Shapeway went on to add the following, and from the time the daily, referring to the daily sacrifice, is removed, and the abomination of the desolator has been given, there will be 1,290 days. Perhaps it is just a coincidence that the 1,290th day is the last day of these 168 days. The daily, or the continual, is referring to the Most High substitution sacrifice that he established through his only begotten Son's shed blood. This verse tells us that the Most High removed the availability of this sacrifice at the end of the 1,260 days of his 42-month witness against you. The reason why he did so is because you have continued to believe into your boy, Saul of Tarsus, the abomination of desolation's lies, and the lies of the other liars that Saul's doctrine brought forth, instead of believing into his truths that he spoke to us through his servants the prophets, including his only begotten Son. Verse 12, blessed is he that waits and touches the 1,335th day. This sounds an awful lot like what Yeshua said when he said, blessed is that servant whom his master finds doing so when he comes. Perhaps it's just a coincidence that Yeshua said this after speaking a parable that no man would know the day or the hour until a certain wise man would be given this information in its time. I believe with all of my being that I have touched this day. I believe that it was on this year's third dove waypoint. If you think that you have until the beginning of the 168 day, great day, to sort this out, you're going to be a recipient of Yahweh's hot indignation. His sixth trumpet prophecy follows the first woe of the fifth trumpet. The 5 months of this fifth trumpet were the five smooth stones that followed his feast of ingathering in the year of his first fruit harvest and ended on the last day of this feast this year. He extended this feast 7 days this year, and the end of the 14 days of this feast brought forth his virgin sign in his dual heavens and his revelation of Meher Shalal Kusbaz. The reason why you have not been a recipient of his wrath during this 5-year period of time is because Yahweh is an Elohim of substitutions. He began to set up this substitution with the affliction that he sent upon his servant Job, and his anointed has been paying the price tag for this substitution on your behalf by being a recipient of that which has resulted from you stealing from the Almighty. He is also an Elohim of irony. Blessed is he that waits and touches the 1,335th day tells us that my having to pay the price for this substitution is going to come to an end on this day. I have lots of reasons for why I believe that his recent third dove waypoint was this day. This means that the time of Jacob's trouble is unfolding at this time in the days that have followed this day, and they have been. The last day of the hour, or the seventh day of the seven vials of the seventh trumpet, will be on 2/27 on the Most High's restored calendar. This is the day that he opened the arch door. His end time timeline is indeed as it was in the days of his servant Noah. I will speak of the many, many other details that tie in with the timing of this day and the hour in future videos. I have had a limited amount of time today because I needed to get prepared for tomorrow's 46th silver trumpet assembly. It took our ancestors 46 years to build the second house that those built unto his name, and there are 46 great whitewashed stones that make up the boulder design of his altar that is in the midst of his house that he has risen up in our midst at this time. And now on this 390th petition day, that is 3 days journey from his 390-day revelation of the year and the month, the Most High's delightful acceptance has cried out the day and even the hour of the vengeance of my Elohim. I have done so for Yahweh my Elohim. Perhaps it's a coincidence that Yeshua used the terminology, the day or the hour. Yeshua's question, who then is the faithful or the believing and wise servant whom his master has appointed upon his household to give him the food in its time, has been answered. It is the delightful acceptance of Yahweh. If I were you, I would turn to being his delightful acceptance with me, or else you are soon going to find out what weeping and gnashing of teeth are all about. I say this because Yeshua finished this no man knows the day or the hour parable, telling us that weeping and gnashing of teeth is going to be the portion for the hypocrites that are eating and drinking with the drunken.